Hello all, welcome back to the Sputnik Challenge. This is the 13th episode, and today we're going to look a little bit at loyalty, because that's going down more and more. And also we want to improve our production now, because we need more money. So what are we going to do about that? Well, first of all, We are in the last episode we started our refinery, so we are actually getting fuel now. And I don't remember, did I set the vehicle hopefully is coming here. Yes, you are going to this distribution office. Hurry up a bit. Thank you. So now we can actually set that we only load fuel there and we unload at all the things here, and we load at 0%. So we just have to wait a little bit until there's more fuel here, that the vehicle will start getting fuel. But for now we don't have any oil, because this pump jack is not going quickly enough for this vehicle to supply enough. So we need more pump jacks. So that's what we're going to do. And so let's first maybe upgrade the road here, and then build that. Do we want to do this? Because it's October 12. Hold on, it's October 28th. Maybe if I make a shortcut here, that we still can supply all the necessities. So let's just remove you. Away. Okay, and then we can build a road like this. So where will you fit? Here. Okay, and then assign all construction offices and set you to high priority. So go and do that, because we still need to go all the way to the border for our gravel and stuff. Maybe I don't want the hulls to participate here, because they will cost a lot with getting steel and stuff like that. So that is one way to increase our productivity. What I do is I record an episode, and sometimes several episodes a day, and then I'm finished recording and I'm sitting on my couch or chair. I'm thinking, oh, I could have done this different or that different. So I always have plans for the next episode to kind of change. Is our vehicle here? We are getting fuel now here. Excellent. Hurry up a little bit. I should upgrade these roads actually. Can we do that now? Maybe. Now would be a good moment if you're gone. And then, like so. So how are we going to upgrade these roads? Because we still need, well, not like this, that's for sure. Go and go like so. And can I go underneath that? No, obviously not. Okay. Then, can you kind of, okay, now we can go around it and we can upgrade you and upgrade you and make a path. Oh no, we can reach there. So I want you to start working on it, and the big huge construction office to start working on it. Okay. We are at a pretty good happiness at 87%. That's not bad at all. We do have some issues with workplaces. We are creating too much uranium. And what I also in the last episode or the episode before that said, I'm getting stuck in my headphones every time. I'm thinking of making an extra processing plant, because these processing plants are pretty cheap, with only 14 tons of steel. So, I thought about doing that. But I... whole sentences. When I put the aggregate storage in, that is this one. I believe you. But this has only one in and one out, so now I'm kind of regretting only putting one aggregate storage in. But we only need this for a small buffer, but because we have a pretty steady flow of people. So what I thought about doing is if we have these small aggregate storages with not you, leave this one. Yeah, and I think this would fit here if we kind of turn it around like so. Maybe I'm better off building the processing plant first, so we know where to connect actually. So you turn you around, press F1 on. So well, the people can kind of walk. Yeah, this is fine. And now let's see if this thing oh no, not like this. See? No, I probably have to remove the footpath first. Let's press pause for a bit. Because I don't want oh, you are still from building. A little bit back. Again, where are you? Here. I have to mirror you again. Yes. As much as possible back. Because then I can get the footpath underneath. Yeah. Like so. And then I have to put the footpath in. That's never going to work here, usually. No. Okay. Let me see. How do you... I want to put it in a bit nicely. Put you back a little bit. So... maybe something like... bend here. Bend back. Is this nice? Or can I even have this bit closer by? No, not like this. Like so. Yeah, I like that better. Okay, then we can add you. And you. Excellent. And now... there isn't any other footpath here. So I'm going to have the people walk around for the time being that we're building the footpath. Please work with me. Thank you. Like so. Okay, now we can press play again. Because it's also almost winter. This was not what I wanted. Construction offices. So, oh, maybe upgrade first. Upgrade. Goal. Footpath. Upgrade. You. And a you. And you. So where are you coming from? Where are you coming from? Oh, you went like so. Okay. Well, if that's quicker, then you do that. Okay, assign. You and also the big construction thing. Assign you and assign you. Maybe I'm removing you. I'm just having this part. And also removing you. Remove. Yes. And add a gravel path. 36,000. So what I want to do, I only want to have these mechanics assigned because I want to keep in mind what we're going to spend. And priority wise, you have a higher priority. Oh yeah. Already did it. So, concrete. Where are you? Oh, that's a long way. Let's speed you up a little bit. So, F1. That's kind of trying to increase the production here a bit. But it's good because we are creating our own fuel now, which will save us a lot of money. So what's next? Once this is done, you, we need to have some attention for the university, because this processing plant will need engineers, and we are already probably 102, and we had 109, I think, 89-ish. You see it decreasing a bit. So we need more university educated people, and I don't want to buy them. So for this to finish, we have 40 tons of steel. And I think we should just assign our hulls to here now. You were here, there, hulls. And I'm telling the hulls, you get your steel, because that's not assigned now, from the border. There. And the same thing I'm going to say to you, get your steel from the border. And I want to check if none of the other constructions have the hulls now. Because that could kill us, kind of. No. And you also not, right? Excellent. So, that means that we are getting our university going. So what's going to the border now? You are getting 100% of steel. 100% of steel. 19% still, all for the university. Excellent. How are we doing people-wise? Because we have... What are you complaining about? A crime? Electronics. Yeah, we turned that off. Maybe we should put that on again to save money. In the end, we need electronics to influence our people. But we are increasing 47%. This is going quite well. 60% you are actually under producing. Okay. Then crime and justice. Excuse me. No, we were first seeing how many empty flats we were still having. 56 and 12, so we can hold off a little bit, but not too long for this to start constructing. So what we can do, but we are pretty busy with the with the dumpers and cranes, the dumpers and mixers now. So maybe after this is done, this and this part, we will start constructing one of these flats to have room for our people, because we're growing pretty steady. Let's show all our actual population. Yeah, okay. Yeah, so what to do here? I was thinking, with the volume we are producing here, I don't think we are ever going to use a train or need a storage this big. So this can go. That was my bad. And what I also said the other episode, I don't think we are going to do trains at all here. Because trains are pretty expensive. And we have all this water here for ships. So I would rather create some kind of hub where from here we can, or maybe multiple ship docks on various areas where we are producing stuff. Because if I look at ships here, and if I look at a cargo harbor, small, it's 57 tons of steel, but it is manageable. And ships, you know, you don't have to lay any infrastructure, and it can load a lot of cargo, a lot of different kinds of cargo. So that being said, one of the things of the Sputnik challenge is we have to build our own ships. So for that, we would in time need to start looking at our ship dock, which is here. And well, we have a big dry dock, but we can use mods, so we can also use smaller shipyards, which we then have to decide if you want to do that. But this is probably after steel, because yeah, that's going to be expensive. So for now we are just using vehicles. Also, vehicles are pretty fast, and we are creating our own bitumen now. So we can also decide to upgrade this road to asphalt. So yeah, how far are you? I see that the mixer, the concrete is coming. Is it being delivered? Are we not getting? No, because you're all... Yeah. You are coming to the rescue. 26, okay. Where did our money go? Yeah, the steel for the university. That makes sense. How much steel do we need here? 6. That we can do. That we can do. We can assign the hulls here, like so. Also, where is the other vehicle? We have 2 on the line. Oh, you've just delivered. Okay. So this is going to take a while until we get our next money in flux kind of thing. Winter's coming. Do we need another snowplow? We have 2 here. So we can go a little bit this direction and there. How many? Go away a little bit. 2 here. 2 here. I think I would like to buy 1 extra. How much are they again? So you are the Winterdienst. Purchase snowplow. Kilometers an hour. 38. For 2,000 extra, I'm going with you. Red. And then I cannot buy a thing anymore for... I'm probably going to send our You go to the custom house, please. Like so. Okay, let's speed you up a little bit. Because it's already getting cold. How are you? And are you... We already have a capacity problem. With a small heat exchanger. Yeah. Hmm. It looks pretty steady at -3. How are you doing? Is our first steel coming? Yes. Excellent. Then we can start building. All mechanisms, everything is assigned. I will add some people from here. 10, 20, 30. Because we can only have one mechanism. So, we are producing our uni. So now we are having the electronics. Yep. So with a crane, this should be finished before winter. We have our extra snowplow here. So yeah, this is just waiting now. You are waiting for the steel. Wait a minute. Have you already loaded the steel? Not yet. Not even yet. Yes, thank you. We are... because I had some test runs. And in one of my test runs, I kind of winged it a little. And I had 0 rubles left because I didn't watch out carefully. I still had a... had a full full load of uranium oxide here, so I sent that to the border, and when that one arrived, half of my people were dead, and the reason for that is F3, because they cannot get water then, and they will die pretty quick. So you are almost done. I did a test run to see if uranium was viable and if I would make that, because I had no idea, because with the Sputnik challenge you have to also put in all your how do you say this? All your water and sewage utilities in. And that's pretty long because all these substations, they require so many ingredients. So yeah, let's see how our... You go for 1 kilometer, right? Excellent. So now we are slowing down. Let's speed you up then. Let's see, where are we plowing? Because this is an issue. If this is not plowed, then the food won't arrive, and meat, and so just leave it at this. Why are you not being plowed? Oh, thank you. So, up until what point are you going? Oh, that's excellent. Okay. We are at 88% happiness. So, let's build some monuments. And I'm probably going for the star monument. Because it has the highest influence. and also the highest ratio. So maybe we can put it here in front of the bus station. Yeah, I have to F1. It's hardly visible. Okay, you do this. And then let's first say that no workers can work there. And then build the pathway. Go there. And then start constructing. No. Constructing. How much do you cost? 19 tons of steel, that's pretty expensive actually. Let's remove the hulls for now. Because monuments. I want to talk to you a little bit of monuments and loyalty. I had a chat with Dennis from the Dennis show yesterday. About monuments and the influence on loyalty, and he said that Frankie Berlin sent him a piece which I will show here. And here you can see from actually it's not really ordered right, because the highest gain you can get from personal cars, then TV, then radio, and then monuments. Well, personal cars, radio, and TV, we are not there for a long shot. Let me see, because I'm in another window, that we're not dying off or something. And then monuments can now gain a maximum loyalty of 40 to 50% depending on the unsatisfied citizens' reaction level. Well, we have pretty harsh citizens' reaction level, so for us that will be at maximum of 40%. So even if we are at 42% now, 41, it just will mean that it doesn't go below 40, and that's what we actually want. And they also are 20% less strength. And this was, I thought climate justice was released way later, or the monuments and the influence, but this was in 2021 already. But this is quite useful to know. That's why we are building you. Are there any cars coming? Are any? Yes, excellent. So I want to go through winter a little bit faster. We only have 13,000 left. So when is our next shipment due? Well, if I tell you to just start going. Because in my mind, we are producing our own fuel now. So that being said, how is our pump check? You are almost done. Yeah, because people are not going to come here very quickly. But we... will you arrive in time? Yeah. That's not an issue. I've seen that for construction people can drive up to nine hours, so yeah. But this is like we are on fast speed and this is very slow. Our happiness is still increasing. So you're almost done now. Okay. So then we can get some more oil to the refinery and refine some real fuel. More fuel, at least. And I forgot to put you off. Why do I forget this every time? And here as well. Don't go to these constructions. This is not possible. Yeah. But here, luckily, no workers are. This is why we are not producing at the moment. Our university. That's also a thing now. We have a lot of professors here. let's kind of tone that down, because I think no educated people are here. No engineers. Hmm? That's not good for our profits. Even decrease you, because I want to keep on making money. Yeah. Yeah. So, are professors coming now? Or university educated people? Well, not in this bus load. The next one. You? Yeah. Just a few. But yeah, but this is a chicken and egg. We need more university educated people. What's our production? Productivity is 89%. It's pretty high. We are at 88%. So what are issues here? No electronics, but that's fixed now. So there's actually not a lot to complain about at this moment, especially since we created some extra jobs here for our unemployment. We can kind of put, yeah, well, 5 is fine. You doing fine. This is fine. So you must be done. Yes. Let's just press play. And now we are going to create a road. I remove this one. And then add a road. Yes. Remove you as well. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Then how about this? And I want to upgrade you to gravel. And I want it upgraded now. And also have a high priority. I think all of our gravel, yeah, they are all doing nothing, so that's fine. 22 with a very snowy road, but this is not what you want to see. This should be the other way around, because now you're going 21 kilometers an hour. Yeah. Yeah, I know this, but you have to start somewhere, and I can increase the loyalty here a bit. 50. Dennis told me yesterday that if you increase the loyalty here, and we don't know the loyalty because we don't have a secret police, that increasing the loyalty here doesn't have an effect. So you don't know the loyalty now. So this is... But I'm so used to it that I just keep doing it. Because I've been doing it for over a year, so yeah. I can say the no snowplow. That would be a wise thing to do, probably. Because beginning from here, you don't need a snowplow. And you also don't need to plow this. That saves us a little bit of plowing time. Also, this doesn't need. Hurry up. I must say, it is winter. It is December 17th, 18th. 89%. This is pretty good. How is our heat doing? Let's see. It's 24 is minus 12. It's pretty steady. But you are saying we are having we're draining too much. Yeah. I do have the feeling that they did change something about the frequency of the snowing. Because in other republics I always was like, you know, once the streets are a bit clear, that's the point when it starts snowing again. But I seem to feel like I see it clean more and more, or my snowplows are more efficient. That can also be a reason. So we have university educated people 100 now. So let's see if that goes up anywhere. Well, not anytime soon. 140, 181. Well, this is higher than I expected. Yeah. Are you doing anything? Yeah, you can absolutely see that our production is kind of plummeting here. But we are creating a road here. I should change this. Should make one construction office for roads only, so the bulldozer gets sent here instead of the excavator. But yeah. Yeah, what are we going to do now? Because it's now waiting for this road to finish, actually. So we can kind of increase our oil production. We need to wait for more people, basically. We can invite some people. No, because I wasn't sure how many I invited not the previous episode. I thought 180 from the third world in total. That was what I written down. Certainly not more. So I will do this next year. And I'm going to go by January 1st. And then you can see in a year, this year, how many people you have imported. This year. Yeah. Because we did this all. Sorry, this is too much. We invited everybody on March the 18th, and then the next year will start on March the 19th. So we had. This is how we could invite so many people. But for the next year, I will just go for the whole year from January 1st to December 31st. I'm actually thinking, after this, that we can kind of start the carbon justice. And after that, or maybe before that, because our criminality is, we are only a year in, 1.5 year. Our criminality is not that high. What are you importing? Soviet gravel, okay. And you are also getting gravel. Oh, okay, it is what it is. How much is one load worth? Oh. That's for the road. Yeah, we are kind of in a fake vacuum now. Because of the lack of people, we are not producing as much as I would have wanted. So we have to wait for our money until we can do stuff. And even if I finish this one, we cannot support it because no people. 110. So we have 10 graduated university students now. See, that's going pretty quick. They're 2 weeks in or something. It's January 1st or 3 weeks. Maybe have all of you study. And then in 2 weeks, we're good to go again. Yeah. Okay. And I think the gravel, here will be some excellent mining options. We already have electricity here. And then I hope that we can have like a production here where we have gravel, and then we can also create a asphalt and concrete. So we don't have to go all the way to the border for that anymore. How are we doing food-wise? We are still at 89%. Alcohol. Excellent. Winters are always periods to really pay close attention. So 125. How is this so quick? How is this so quick? I have no idea. Because they were imported from the third world, they were pretty smart to begin with or something. Because they all need schooling, almost all. But we can decrease our number of people here now. Okay. So we get more people here. $10,000. We need these exports. It's getting pretty busy in our little city. So let's just plan crime and justice, and let's really pay close attention to the numbers. Crime and justice, where are you again? Here. So I'm going for the small versions here, and a police station would be best. I think somewhere here. I can also wait 1.5 months so that we can get some good. I'm going to wait for 1.5 months because I don't like building in winter. I can't see and the color hurts my eyes. So, yeah, we are having one of them going. How are you doing? How many university educated people do we have? 136. I don't know. This probably has to do. I think this has to do with the fact that these were all older people imported from the third world or something. I don't know. But these are all young. Yeah, 33. And he is actually university educated now. I think that has to do with me. Hold on. With me importing 29 people from the third world. Yeah. 1.7. There are some older people, 29, 33. Because these people are also older. like if you import university educated people or people from the immigrants from the Soviet bloc, they're usually pretty young. But we are getting enough university educated people now, so for us this is a pretty good development. We can produce stuff again. So, 8,000. I'm waiting for the delivery to be done here. Oh, not you. I don't know. Here, 20. Eh. That's what I was waiting for. So, are you almost full? Yeah. Yeah, so you're going as well. So then we have like 30. I like that this is going again. 89% still. Okay. So this is all to the steel part. Yeah, I don't want to build this now. I want to wait. Okay. Crime and justice we were doing. Crime and justice. How about we say we leave that for the next episode? Because I see that we are 46 minutes in. Yeah, we had to wait. But we, our university people, went from 100 to 144 in 6 weeks or something. Well, that's crazy. It's just... Okay, and next episode we are going to finish this monument and we are probably going to have to create some extra housing and we are going to plan our crime and justice system and probably also the gravel system. And I don't know what I'm doing first. If I plan the whole gravel, quarried stone and concrete cement things like this, then we don't have to go all the way to the border to produce the whole crime and justice system. And what I was saying, I think we do have some time for that. So I think that that would be the plan of action. Still no electronics. Yeah. Go to the shop. Okay. I think we're going to do that for the next time. I hope you enjoyed this episode. This is a very slow-paced but easygoing episode. I'm totally forgetting to put my oil tank to get the oil from there. We will do this all the next episode. Hope to see you next time. Bye bye.